Hi guys, today I want to build the sidechain effect on the modular system without using a compressor. I mean, I know it's not the complete new topic and also not the reinvention of the wheel, but I'm still impressed how good and fast this works. I must say all the credits go to Colin Bendis, who describes this method in the wonderful book Patch and Tweak. I've put the link in the description just in case if you want to check it out. So I have tried this a lot of times and it works really good and, like I said, very fast. So I want to share this with you guys from scratch. Okay, first I connect my VCOs here to the left to my amps. Therefore I need just some random waveforms that I connect them to my amplifiers. So this goes right here. Let me just put them to zero. This goes, this is the wrong direction. This goes here, and this goes into my first channel. Second waveform, take a waveform called Blade, which is kind of a mixture, I think, between pulse and sawtooth. So this is saw. And this goes right here. Of course, every oscillator needs a CV input, which is then connected to this module over here. It's just an octave module for changing the octaves. Okay. The VCOs are then patched to the filter section. You see they are already pre-patched into the inputs of the EMS filters. In order to give the sound a shape, I add an envelope, this one, to the filters, one for the filters and one for the amp section. So that's what we do right now. I connect the first of the dual envelope to the filter CV inputs, and the second one I connect to the CV inputs of my amps. Voila. And this sounds now like this. Okay, to achieve that sidechain effect now, I need a negative envelope. And I will explain in a minute why is that. For me, the easiest thing is to affect the filter section, because I need the cutoff to go down when the bass drum comes in and then rise up again to the regular cutoff level. And here comes the negative or inverted envelope into our game. It allows me to push down the filter level when this trigger signal comes in. That's the technique actually. And with the attack, decay, sustain and release knob, you can now exactly define the shape of the envelope. I never did this before, it's strange. I will connect now the output of the bass drum, the gate out, actually the gate output of the drum sequencer, to the input of my envelope here, which is a Döpfer A140. And the special thing about it, it has an inverse output that is exactly what we need for our task. Okay, now I connect the inverse output to the modulation inputs of my filters. So let me just connect these via the multipliers, because I need I need two. And here they go. Okay, I show it first to you without bass drum, and then you can better hear the difference. So that's our regular system, sequence. System. That's our regular sequence that you know already. And now I add the bass drum. And look, now I can play around, for example, with the release time, and you hear exactly what it affects in the sidechain effect. And one important thing, of course, if you like my videos, hit subscribe and hit the notification button. That helps me to make much more of these wonderful videos. I record all these separate outputs with my performance mixer, which is in a separate case right here. I have also made a video especially about this recording unit and my Matrix Halo interface. So don't miss to check that out. I can also create the sidechain effect with the amp section instead of the filter section of the system. Better said, I have to connect the inverse output of the envelope then to the CV inputs of my two voltage controlled amps, which is literally like moving the faders of a mixing table to zero whenever this sidechain signal comes in, you know. So let me quickly patch the cables and then you can hear the difference, or maybe not. Look, I disconnect these two cables from the modulation inputs of the filters. And when I activate the bass drum, it's now no effect. Okay, so this is the multiple of the inverted envelope. So green I connect to my right amplifier, and the white cables come into the left section. And okay, this is without bass drum. Oops. It's a slightly different sound, of course. And I can play around with the release time again. Thank you. So you see, when I add more and more voices, it becomes really impressive. So this is still the bass sequence now, and I add more and more sequences now. Change the rhythm now, and the sidechain effect follows. What I like about this approach is that the audio is not being processed through a second instance like a compressor, for example, but instead of being controlled by a certain amount of voltage. How often did I say the word voltage in this video? So like I said, this is one of some other approaches to get this effect in your modular system. You can of course do it with a compressor that has a sidechain input. I will put the link in the description of this envelope that I used here in this video, as well as some other modules. So you can check it out for yourselves. So take care, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.